We meet together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires turn, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Friends, God the Father forgives us in Christ and heals us by the Holy Spirit. Let us therefore put away all anger and bitterness, all slander and malice, and confess our sins to God our Redeemer. Almighty God,
our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbor, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins, for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Who has measured the waters in the hollow of his hand, a
the map of the heavens we can span, and close the dust of the earth in the measure, and weigh the mountains in scales, and the hills in the balance. Who has directed the spirit of the Lord, or as his counselor has instructed him? Who did he consult for his enlightenment? And who taught him the path of justice? Who taught him knowledge and showed him the way of understanding? Even the nations are like a drop from the bucket and are counted as dust as the scales. See, he takes out the spires like fine dust. Lebanon will not provide fuel enough, nor are its animals enough for a burnt offering. All the nations are as nothing before him. They are accounted by him as less than nothing and emptiness. Why do you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel? My way is hidden from the Lord, and my right is disregarded by my God. Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint and strength to the powerless. Even youth will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. This is the word of the Lord.
Psalm 8. O Lord our Governor, how glorious is your name in all the world.
Your majesty on the heavens is praised,
out of the mouths of the ears of the rest. You have founded a stronghold against your foes, that you might still the enemy and the avenger. Mindful of them, mere human beings, that you should seek them out.
You have made them little lower than the angels, and crowned them with glory and honor.
You have given them dominion over the works of your hands, and put all things under their feet. The birds of the air, the fish of the sea, and whatsoever moves in the paths of the sea.
Thank you.
to which Jesus had directed them. When they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. And Jesus came and said to them, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always, to the end of the age." Friends, this is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you. You see, the doctrine of the Trinity is at one and the same time the most essential of our faith, and yet the least understood parts of our Christian tradition. And today I will not try to add to that, but follow in words of others who have gone before me. You see, the word Trinity in the creed that we will read later is personas. Persons, like the mask of Greek actors, wear it to play different characters. It is always the same person behind the three personas. And there are many more analogies, such as an egg with three parts, a clover with three leaves, or H2O with three states. That one I had to look up because science is not my language. But in all of these, I fear they do not do justice to God's transcendent nature. They tend to present God as somehow divisible, and he is not divisible. God reveals God's self as Creator, the Son, and the Spirit. Karl Barth puts it such: one God in three ways of being. strange that something so fundamental to our faith as Christians took so long and still undecided to be expressed in words. But perhaps that is the whole point. The Trinity or Trinity Sunday is not a formula. It is more than an academic doctrine within theology. It is our faith. It is the way in which we experience and bear witness to the living God. It is through experience that many of the first disciples were able to explain who God is and was. Now, I'm not calling you to go out to search out experiences and proclaim it in the name of God. Or am I saying that if you haven't had an experience, you do not know the Trinity? I am saying this. We are drawn into the threefold life of God that calls us into life, that breathes the image of God into us and sends us out to live. It is the living within this unity that shows God's love for us and we to others. God is interested in our personal story, cares for each person, and gives us a sense of belonging. It is life itself, and that is what we proclaim. There has to be a living engagement with the triune God. Therefore, it can't be one experience or one event that we know, but a movement within a community living within the presence of God, which then transforms the environment around us. We are dwelling in the heart of this Trinity, to be in relationship with one another. And although I may have a problem with the gender particularity in the traditional form of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, I haven't found an alternative that brings this engagement so beautifully. We live, move, and have our very being within the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The life that flows within the Trinity is the life that we are so graciously caught up within, that builds our common life together. This is the experience, then, that I suggest. Not a moment, but a movement of life. And so, therefore, our Christian life is to have life itself grow each day in our loving communion with God and one another. Now that which we have received internally, we are to express externally to one another and others beyond our circle. So when communities are broken and divided, when people distrust one another, when there is violence or abuse, when people are not given the dignity of equality as human beings, those communities fail to reflect the life, the image of God in this Trinity. For this Trinity seeks justice, speaks peace, grows in love, listens and cares. Life where human beings, regardless of class, creed, color, gender, or sexuality, deserves to have the fullness of their humanity engaged and flourishing. This is our blessed Trinity. It is life. And so, it is in this life that I believe Jesus sends us out with the commission, "Go, therefore, and make disciples." Life and love is what we are caught up in, is what we are called then to bring others into. It is what we are called in this kingdom to build together. Bring people into life itself. To believe that God is a Trinity of divine ways of being is to receive God's merciful invitation to daily breath of life, to be there mentally, physically, eternally, spiritually, in community with the saints who have gone before us, our ancestors who have journeyed the way. We continue in this story, journeying with them and speaking life and love. Every time we worship, or prayer, or turn our hearts towards God, we complete this divine unity and stand within this Trinity. And so my prayer for you this week is that on this Trinity Sunday, we may draw closer within this relationship, that we may be able to feel life and love, to speak then of this life and love, that we may grow together as a community, calling others into this life. That in drawing closer and within the Trinity, we therefore become God's beloved community on earth, within his blessed Trinity. Amen.
Stand, and on this Trinity Sunday we'll say the Nicene Creed together, which is on page 5. So on page 5 we say together, "We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Would you please sit for our prayers?
On this Trinity Sunday, we have come before you, Lord, to offer our praise and glory. You are God the Creator, giving us richly all things to enjoy. You are Christ, the Saviour of the world, made flesh to set us free. You are the Spirit of truth and love, willing to dwell in us. You are holy and blessed, one God, eternal Trinity. Be near to us. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, we pray for your church throughout the world, for those that are thriving and those in need of your guidance. We give thanks for our church and its people here, and acknowledge all the gifts you have given us. We ask you to open wide our hearts, that we may welcome all people to this place, to share our love for you, that here they may find life in abundance. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, you have chosen women and men to serve you in the ministry of your church, and given them a perfect example in the person of your Son. Pour your blessings on your servants today, especially those in our own church, Andrew and Sharma, and all others that serve to bring abundant skills, time and dedication to this church and community, that by word and deed they also may proclaim your love and build our community. Lord, in your mercy. Lord of the universe, we praise you for your creation. You have provided us with everything it needs for life and health. Grant that the resources of this earth may be neither hoarded nor squandered, but that all may share your gifts. Lord, in your mercy. We remember all who bear the responsibility of leadership, for heads of state, ambassadors and political advisors. Let your will for our world be accomplished through the decisions that they make, and give them your vision of service through generosity and equality to achieve peace and reconciliation in our communities and our countries. Lord, we pray for peace in the world. Create in us a love for peace, a peace that makes whole what is now broken. We remember those who struggle against injustice, for men and women who have to establish love as supremacy in violence and oppressive societies, for those whom war and famine have robbed them of homes, families and friends. May they be filled with your strength and wisdom, and grant that where your will has not been followed, your divine compassion may heal. Lord, in your mercy. We remember this morning those who are unwell, sad or lonely, and those who are brave and patient when things are going wrong. We pray that they may be aware of your comforting presence, and know that in your hands they are loved. We remember before God those who have died, and those who mourn. Lord, we pray for all whose life is saddened by the death of a loved one. Be with them in their loneliness, and let them know that Jesus Christ is the light of the world, a light which no darkness can quench. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, we ask you to lead us into the coming week. Help us to know that you are close by us, and when we face hard decisions or difficult work, when we enjoy ourselves and have fun with others, may we know that you share these times with us. You are the three in one, the one in three, of whom all nature has creation, eternal Father, Spirit Word, praise to the Lord of our salvation. Salvation is of Christ the Lord. Merciful Father,
would you please stand where possible for the peace? We are the body of Christ in the one Spirit. We were all baptized into one body. Let us then. then pursue all that makes for peace and builds up our common life. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Friends, let us offer one another a sign of peace.
Continue our service with our offertory hymn, which is hymn number 203.
Thank you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to set before you, which earth has given and human hands have made, become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to set before you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, become for us the cup of salvation.
Blessed
be God forever. If you'd like to follow the Eucharistic prayer, you can find it on page 15, prayer B on page 15. The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and right to give thanks.
A special preface for Trinity Sunday. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For with your only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord. All that you reveal of your glory, the same we believe of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, without any difference or inequality. We, your holy church, acclaim you, Father of majesty unbounded, your true and only Son, worthy of all worship, and the Holy Spirit, advocate and guide. Three persons we adore, one in being and equal in majesty. And so with angels and archangels, with cherubim and seraphim, we sing forever of your glory. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me.
Great is the mystery of faith.
Rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we in the company of John the Baptist and all the saints may praise and glorify you forever through Jesus Christ our Lord, by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body because we all share in one body.
Lord, son of God,
Just a reminder that every Sunday there are people in the side chapel who would be very happy to pray with you or offer anointing for healing. So if you'd like to, please make your way into the side chapel after the service. There's evening prayer here at 4 o'clock this afternoon. You'd be most welcome. And there's a set communion service on Thursday, because it's Corpus Christi, which is the day that we give thanks for the gift of the communion service itself. So that's 7 o'clock this Thursday evening. Thank you to everybody involved in church cleaning, which is a great communal endeavor. We were here yesterday, and just because the fun never stops, there will also be church cleaning next month on the first Saturday. We're limbering up for a summer fair in the church on the 15th of July. And I know that there's a list at the back of the church just on the table. If you know that you're going to be around on the 15th and had time to run a stall or offer things towards a stall, please sign the list at the back of the church, and your help will be very gratefully received. The deanery as a whole is going on an outing to Bishop's Waltham, and that's next Saturday. There's an Eventbrite link, and there may well be still tickets. I'm sure that you'll realise if you go onto the site and try and sign up, if there are still tickets, they'll be there on the website. If you'd like to go but would need some help just using this Eventbrite link, please mention it to myself or to Shona, and we would gladly assist you. I think most people know this, but not everybody perhaps. Victoria, having been our wonderful director of music, will return to the country of her birth in Australia, not that far away. And she's been preparing and all the practical arrangements. It will, of course, be a moment of sadness for us because she has given so much to this community. There's going to be a party which is going to be a mixture of evensong and a ceilidh on the evening of Saturday, the 1st of July. So please put that in your diaries. And for the musically minded, if you'd like to bring a copy of the Messiah to join in the Alleluia chorus, but that's not compulsory. So if you'd like to come and do bring along some food and drink, and we're going to have a big shared meal that evening to give thanks for Victoria and to wish her well for her great move to Australia. So that's the 1st of July. I'm going to leave you to read all the other notices. I would, however, like to invite Neil up to the front, because we didn't get a chance to sing for his birthday, and I would really love to invite him to come forward. So if he can bear it, I would like to invite Neil to come so that we can sing for him. And are there any other birthdays, either in the last couple of weeks or in the coming week, that we should be celebrating? Neil, it's on its own public humiliation. So we would like to celebrate the gift of Neil to our Prince. Come forward. Fantastic.
Good.
Good. You're a kind man, Prince. It's probably not my birthday at all. You're sorry, Neil. We give thanks to your birthday as well. So we'd like to sing for Neil and beautiful anthem singing. I'd like to give you a round of applause. God the Holy Trinity, make you strong in faith and love. Defend you on every side and guide you in truth and peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be upon you this day and evermore. Amen.
Friends, go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Amen.